Now Simeon was the second son of Jacob and Leah. He was a strong man, and he became jealous of Joseph, and he is the instigator to plot against Joseph. The copy of the words of Simeon, the things which he spoke to his sons before he died, in the 120th year of his life, at which time Joseph his brother died. And when Simeon was sick, his son came to visit him, and he strengthened himself, and sat up and kissed him, and said, "Hearken, my children, to Simeon, your father, and I will declare to you what things I have in my heart. I was born of Jacob as my father's second son, and my mother Leah called me Simeon, because Yahweh had heard her prayer. Moreover, I became strong exceedingly, and I shrank from no achievement, nor was I afraid of aught. For my heart was hard, and my liver was immovable, and my bowels without compassion, because favor also had been given from the Most High to men in my soul and body. For in time my youth I was jealous of many things of Joseph, because my father loved him beyond all. And I set my mind against him to destroy him, because the prince of deceit set forth the spirit of jealousy and blinded my mind, so that I regarded him not as a brother, nor did I spare even Jacob my father. But his Yahweh said, Yahweh of his fathers set forth his angel and delivered him out of my hands. For when I went to Shechem to bring ointment for the flocks, and Reuben to Duham, there were no necessities in all of our stores. Judah my brother sold him to the Ishmaelites. And when Reuben heard these things, he was grieved, for he wished to restore him to his father. But on hearing this, I was exceedingly wroth against Judah, in that he let him go away alive. And for 5 months I continued wroth against him. And Yahweh restrained me and withheld me from the power of my hands, for my right hand was half withered for 7 days. And I knew, my children, that because Joseph, this had befallen me, and I repented and wept, and I besought Yahweh God, that my hand might be restored, and that I might hold aloof for all the pollution and the envy, and for all the folly. For I knew that I had devised an evil thing before Yahweh and Jacob my father on the account of Joseph my brother, in that I envied him. And now, my children, hearken unto me, and beware of the spirit of deceit and envy. For envy ruleth over the whole mind of man, and suffereth him neither to eat, nor to drink, nor to do anything. But if it ever suggest to him to destroy him, that he availeth, so long as he that is envied flourish, that he envieth fade away. 2 years before I afflicted my soul with fasting and the fear of Yahweh, and I learneth that deliverance from envy cometh from the fear of God. For if a man flee to Yahweh, for the evil spirit runneth away from him, and his mind is lightened. And fear forward, henceforth he sympathizes with him who he envied, and forgiveth those who were hostile to him. So ceaseth his from his envy. Chapter 2. And my father asked concerning me, because he saw that I was sad. And I said unto him, I am pained in my liver. The word liver is the same as your heart to an Israelite. And I mourned more than they all, because I was guilty of selling Joseph. And when we went down from Egypt, he bound me as a spy, and I knew that I was suffering justly, and I grieved not. Now Joseph was a good man, and the spirit of Yahweh was in him, being compassionate and pitiful. He bore no malice against me, but loved me even as the rest of his brethren. Beware, therefore, my children, of all jealousy and envy, and walk in singleness of heart, that Yahweh may give you also the grace and glory and blessing upon your hearts, even as we saw in Joseph's case. And in his days he reproached us not concerning this thing, but loved us in his own soul. And behold, his own son glorified us, and gave us riches and cattle and fruit. Do you also, my children, love each other, his brethren with a good heart, and the spirit of envy will withdraw from you. For this maketh savage the soul, and destroyeth the body. It will cause anger, and in war in mind, stirreth up all deeds of blood, leadeth the mind with frenzy, and causeth torment in the soul, and trembling in the body. For even in sleep malicious, jealously gnawing, and with the wicked spirit, disturbeth the soul, and causeth the body to be trembled, and walketh in mind to sleep confusion, and is wicked and poisonous spirit, so appealeth unto men. Therefore, as Joseph, comely in appearance, and godly in look, does no wickedness, dwelleth in him. For come of tremble of the spirit, and face manifesteth. And now, my children, make your hearts good before Yahweh, and your hearts straight before men, and you shall find grace before Yahweh the men. Beware, therefore, of fornication, for fornication is mother of all evils, separating from Yahweh, and bringing bear to Belial. For I have seen it inscribable in the writing of Enoch, that your sons shall be corrupted in fornication, and shall do harm to the sons of Levi with the sword, but they shall not be able to withstand Levi, for he shall wage the war with Yahweh, and shall conquer all your host. And there shall be few in the number, divided in Levi and Judah, and there shall be none of you of sovereignty, even as also your father prophesies in his blessings. Chapter 3. Behold, I have told you all things, that I may be acquitted of your sins. Now if you remove from you your envy and all your stiff-neckedness, as the rose shall be my bones flourished in Israel, and as my lily my flesh with Jacob, and my odor shall be as the odor of Libanus, and the cedars shall holy ones be multiplied before me forever, and their branches shall stretch afar off. Then shall perish the seed of Canaan, and the remnant shall not be unto Amalek, and all of the Cappadocians shall perish, and all the Hittites shall be utterly destroyed. And they shall fail in the land of Ham, and all the people shall perish. And they shall all the earth rest from trouble, and all the world under the heaven from war. And the mighty one of Israel shall glorify Sham. And the word of Yahweh shall appear on the earth, and he himself shall save men. Then shall all the spirits of deceit be given unto trodden under the foot, and men shall rule over the wicked spirits. And then shall I arise in glory, and be blessed the Most High because of his marvelous works, because Yahweh hath taken the body and eaten with men, and saved men. And now, my children, obey Levi and Judah, and be not lifted up against these two tribes. For from them shall arise unto you the salvation of Yahweh. For Yahweh shall rise up from Levi, as it were a high priest, and from Judah there and from Judah as it were a king, Yahweh and man, and he shall save all the Gentiles and all the race of Israel. Therefore I give you these commandments, that you also shall command your children, that they may observe them throughout their generations. And when had made an end of commanding his sons, he slept with his fathers, and began 120 years old. And they laid him in a wooden coffin, and took his bones to Hebron. And they took them up secretly during a war of the Egyptians, for the bones of Joseph and the Egyptians guarded in the tombs of the kings. For the sorcerers told them that on the departure of the bones of Joseph, there should be throughout all the land of darkness and gloom, and exceeding great plagues of the Egyptians, so that even with a lamp a man should not recognize his brother. And the sons of Simeon wailed their father, and they were in Egypt until the day of their departure by the hand of Moses.